people that look like you and me, fighters to make sure that our communities are safe worldwide, fighters for standing up for things that are important to us. So we want to welcome them. We want to welcome them with open arms, and we want to welcome them standing up when
you look at me and rock your
right. I commend all of you for being here, and everyone is struggling trying to bring forward a fact: poverty. No one believes it. A lot of people simply do not believe that kids are hungry or elderly are hungry. I have a solution. Let's ask the kids. Let's ask them, how many kids are hungry? Why not? Why can't we ask our kids in class how many are hungry? Well, because we don't want to single anyone out. So very quickly, anonymous polling. We can anonymously poll our kids every day. It should be a regular part of class. Instead of singling them out, do you or don't you know a question individually, I can ask, how many kids did their homework? And I'll get a response from the class as a percentage poll. It's called anonymous poll. And you flip a coin, the kid answers yes if it's heads, and he answers the truth if it's tails. So if I ask you a sensitive question, you might respond yes or no, but I can't tell from your response whether you're responding to the question or whether you're responding to the result of your toss. Now what this means is, and I think this is why it's very important to you, you're trying to light fires under people. People aren't believing you. People have hearts already. We already want to do things. I think it's our eyes that are lacking. Okay? I think when people hear, one out of five kids are criminally victimized. You talked about people who can't defend themselves. Even an elderly person usually has more wherewithal. They know who to call, or someone to call. They have someone to call. Kids, they have no one. If they're in crisis, the statistics are one out of five are criminally attacked by 18. Criminally means it's met the criminal definition. You can be taken to jail for doing something. Now, most of us as parents, we get upset way before it reaches criminality. So if it's one out of five, there was the Million Father March. 200,000 fathers of the Million Father March should be up in arms about the one out of five statistic. So we hear these statistics and they go in one ear out the other. It's like stepping over dead bodies. We've all seen that black, grainy video of a store being robbed, and this woman is reaching, stepping over a dead body to get to her coffee. And we're all looking down on that person. How dare she step over a dying person for a coffee? We do that every time we hear the statistic of one in five kids abused. And we let it go in one ear and out the other. Same thing with poverty.
We try to put a human face on it. So then it's difficult.
Every morning it should be a part of class. We talk about inclusion. If I'm overly smart...
Let me jump the record up. So let me talk about your logic. So kids go to the classroom. Every morning you want to ask them if they're hungry. Half the class says yes, then what?
Then I want to look you and their parents in the eye and say, it's not some other kids that are hungry. I want to go to these people here in this room and say, half of your kids are hungry, and I want to jump up and down and scream. I can't scream quite as much because it's like, well, they might be hungry, or it's some other kids, or it's the statistics in a paper. Okay, I think this individualizes it. I think it'd be very powerful.
Got it. Thank you for your comment. We appreciate it. Yes, sir.
Hi there. My name is Justin, and I've been a political and protest.
Tough questions. That is not an excuse. And I'm out of time.
Yes. To wrap up, please.
To wrap up, please consider, and perhaps we should have a discussion. We could have a meeting, board meetings, talk with you people, whatever is necessary. One thing I was very encouraged, you are all so motivated, and we're all talking about money. Please don't think about any of these things. It's not an issue of money. It is an issue of acknowledging that there's a problem and then worrying about it. If a child is on fire, and that's what we're talking about, this is literal abuse, and they're on fire now, not next month, not last month, it's not someone else's kids. As we're speaking, out of a quarter of a million kids, students, 50 are newly being abused as we're speaking, and they're